What's up, guys? This is my second commentary this week, or for this week. Yeah, I'm on commentary video number 2, and I'm planning to make at least 14, I hope. Which I will. Yeah, I will. Just don't bring out your pitchforks and torches yet, people. I swear to God. And look at this, people. I brought artillery! Blasphemy. And so did my opponent. His name is Ty Luca. Luker. And he's gonna shower me with his howitzers, his 6-inch howitzer. Alright, let me show his build. Of course, he's France, I'm Prussia. The usual stupid major nations. I'm sorry. Couldn't choose nothing else. Against France, you gotta go Prussia. And he brought his 6-pounder horse artillery as well. He brought 4 Voltigos. Let me count this. Cavalry force, 1 Cuirassier, 1 Chasseliers. Okay, yeah, I know y'all like to hear that mispronunciation, but okay. The 7E Regiment, the Chevaliers Lanciers. Where the hell is that other one? Ah, there we go. Okay, 2 Chasseliers total. And it's 1 Leaguer Lancer. Okay. I did a premature cavalry charge onto his artillery right here, because when they're unlimbered like that, there's a glitch going on where they have so many hit points and you can't hit shit. Well, apparently you can hit that, but you can't hit these artillery pieces. And over here, I'm going to do other cavalry charges, hit and run tactics on his Chevex Leaguers, or Lanciers. Yeah, they have 1 more melee and 1 more charge stat than the regular Leaguer Lancers. And my Lancers here are getting ganged up from the square. I'm going to focus my artillery fire onto these cavalry units of my opponent. And this match was extremely laggy. I mean, extremely laggy. Laggier than your grandma's face. I'm telling you, it was laggy. Extremely. And I told my opponent, because he was the host, he was like, I swear to God, it's never like this. I was like, dude, you gotta lay off that porn. I'm sorry, I can't. No, he didn't say that, but I'm just gonna theoretically picture him thinking that, because it gives me pleasure making him suffer. Okay, y'all didn't hear that. That was my evil side. I have a second personality. His name is Hugo. Okay, that's Tyler the Great's little joke about me. So his infantry force is 2-3 Polish Legion so far, 2 Fusiliers of Line, 2 Old Guard. This is a really nice build so far. Okay, that's his build. I told you his artillery, his cav, his skirmishers, oh, and his general staff. Who could forget this bastard? But that is his force, and let me lower the sound, because this is freaking loud. No, wait, what am I doing? That's the master volume. Yeah, let me lower that. Okay. So this is our match here, people. I brought artillery for a new strategy of mine. I wanted him to... I was afraid of my left flank, so I placed my artillery on my right flank so he'll focus mostly on that, where I had my best troops. I wanted him to just split up his army. I did my guards on my center tactic, where I wanted him to focus the majority of his flanks against mine. I wanted him to place units on his flanks so he could worry about them. So he weakened his center. He had 1 old guard there, but initially he had so much more cavalry and infantry on his center, and that was too late. He did a premature cavalry charge here. He's taking free shots from my musketeers. I thought he was chasing my Prussian fusiliers. I thought that would be the logical choice, but nope. So I completely routed his right flank, and I'm still facing his left flank here. I'm reforming, and I'm pointing my center against him. Like Napoleon commits his guard in the most dire situation, I committed my center for the situation that means kick ass. So when I'm ready to start kicking the ass right back to my opponent, I commit my center. And I'm not meaning that in a negative way, kicking ass. I mean that as in I want to destroy you very quickly, because I want to go eat my pizza that I just ordered during this match. Which is a very positive thing if you're thinking like me. But anyway, I'm gonna make my new front. I'm gonna charge ahead to my little infantry pushes, focus on the Volatica, and after that's gone, I'm gonna focus on these Fusiliers aligned with my musketeers that I know I can dominate these stupid infantry units that I just want to get rid of off this field. And he's still focusing his six entablature on my center against my guards. That's a good move. He should really retreat. I mean, I'm not the person who I dislike kiting a lot, but in this situation you need to retreat. But this match was laggy, so you can't blame him for the 1 minute delay here, because this was laggy than like 60 files of porn. Okay, I'm telling you, it was terribly laggy. Like, the screen frozes then goes back after a minute. I mean, I had this with another match, but I at least was able to move my screen, you know, like this. I was able to do that. But during my first match against Totem Carton, it was just blank. It was frozen. Nothing was moving but his units. So I didn't know if that was a cheat or nothing, but I was like, okay, dude, quit lagging the match. He goes, ew, it's you! I'm like, okay, yeah. That's very inconspicuous by blaming me after I blame you. Okay. So he has an old guard unit here. I wish he would have pushed up here. I mean, it's only against a musketeer, and he would have turned my flank, at least folded it, and he would have released, which is a 6-2, he would have released some of the pressure on his center, but it's too late. I committed my guards on his center, and his center is completely routed. So is his left flank. Yeah, that's his left. Okay. I always get the left and right flanks mixed, because everyone's like, okay, you mean his left flank? No, I mean it's right. We get that confused. You know what I mean, people. You hate that too. So I'm gonna place my lancers behind his musketeers, because I know my lancers are cowards when it comes to these heavy cav now, because these heavy cav have been apted up. They're more effective. So I'm gonna commit my rush. I'm gonna speed up a little bit. He's just doing suicidal charges with his 6-inch howitzer, which I am happy to oblige. Take some bullets to the face. Why did I form a square? Oh yeah, cav. Okay. Idiot. Nice. Yeah, I'm not gonna form to a square. I actually believe this cav charge would have turned my entire center against me. Because my foot guards here had only 53 men, so if they had like 47, he would have completely crashed right through this unit into my Prussian Fusiliers. I wouldn't have formed square in time with my foot guards. This match was laggy, remember that. So it was like a 6-second delay, and this is getting kind of laggy. I don't know why. I'm not downloading nothing. So I'm going to retreat. It's really dumb to face an old guard unit with just a musketeer. You want to overwhelm the musketeer. Overwhelm the old guard. As the term goes, focus on the weak, overwhelm the strong. Well, it's really overcome the weak and overwhelm the weak and overcome the strong. That's Sun Tzu's words. That's Napoleon's words. And Sun Tzu's words is focus on the weak, pretty much choose your battles, and overwhelm the strong. So fight where you're strong is what he's trying to say, and I base my entire strategies on that. Alright, let me speed to this crap. I really want to just kill these three units and begin my other commentaries for you people. And he's going to retreat his old guard. Who retreats an old guard? That is an insult to the whole term of old guard. You're supposed to be experienced, but no. I'm going to charge up my lancers and make them stay in place and take the volleys like men. But no, he wants to keep retreating. So, bad Ty Luger, bad. So he's gonna go into melee with my lancers. I ride him his Volatigas, and this is the last stand of the old guard. Did I just make a pun? Is that a pun? Never mind, I'm like, don't answer that. So I'm gonna take some free shots at this old guard unit. They're gonna continue to march in melee against my lancers, and they were gonna choose to go into melee with my center here, but they routed, so bad luck. But this was a good game to my opponent, without the lag. Let's do this again sometime. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm going to begin my third video for this week. See y'all then.